3D Hubs used to be the place to go and crowdsource 3D printing, but they basically went out of business and disappeared. What happened there? So, first of all, I know everybody's down there in the comments already. 3D Hubs did not go out of business. No, they didn't. They shut down their core business, pivoted to just general manufacturing, and changed the name of the company to Hubs when they were purchased. So no, they didn't go out of business, they just disappeared and ceased to exist. Tomato, tomato. But what happened was, yes, 3D Hubs did start out as a way for anybody in the world with a 3D printer to list their printer on the site, and then if somebody had a project that needed to be 3D printed, they could upload the file, pick the printer closest to them in their general area, and then Hubs would facilitate the file exchange and payment and that kind of stuff. And it was a good model and a good idea, especially when everybody was going gung-ho about home or local manufacturing and 3D printing. But the problem was they couldn't make any money and everybody was mad at them all the time. Let me explain. We've done a few other videos about why Slant 3D has the exact same printer throughout our facility and why we don't really believe in home 3D printing. And we'll link to those around here so that you can actually watch those and get the context. But the main problem is there is no way to reliably crowdsource, especially desktop 3D printing. There are a number of manufacturer aggregators like Xometry and Fictive who use multiple companies who are all producing parts, but the difference is those companies are all using the exact same machine underneath the same certification standards in between companies. So they know that they're making the exact same part regardless of which one of those contract companies in the network makes it. That was something that was not possible for 3D Hubs to do when they were going, because somebody would have an Ultimaker, and somebody would have a MakerBot, and a Stratasys, and a Prusa, and some DIY thing that they built in the garage. And even though they were selling the part to the customer as an FDM printed part at 0.2 resolution, how and who made the part really changed what the part ended up being, especially around tolerances and around color and material, because white is not white, PLA is not PLA, and FDM is not FDM if it's not the same machine. Each one of those things can vary a little bit from one supplier to the next. And in desktop 3D printing, and FDM 3D printing kind of more broadly, there are very few clear standards in place of how to certify if a part is done well. And in a crowdsource situation like that, it's almost impossible to have a universal standard, because an independent person with a $300 machine is not going to get it certified and will not have the capacity to have it certified. So that is why 3D Hubs basically disappeared in its original format. The idea was good of crowdsourcing the machinery across thousands of people with thousands of machines, but it was impossible to create a consistent, reliable product for the customer who was using the platform. So that's why they eventually had to abandon it and just go towards more traditional manufacturing with very tight controls and much higher levels of certification, which is really good for the customers, and the customers are the ones who pay the bills. But again, this is why at Slant 3D we only use one type of machine and we are very stringent about our suppliers and that kind of stuff, because if you have multiple different machines inside of a facility, they're very difficult to maintain, but they're also going to create different parts. So if you have a few machines like this and a few machines like that, but they're all working on the same part, they're not going to be making the same part. So that's why we only use our Slant boxes that we control, make sure are backwards compatible, and produce the same or at least consistent results over time, rather than having a bunch of disjointed pieces of machinery working on that kind of stuff. And that's why 3D Hubs moved away from it too. Hopefully that answers your question about kind of what happened to 3D Hubs and why they left that model behind. When you're manufacturing a product, it's really important to be consistent over time. If there's other topics about mass production 3D printing that you'd like us to take a look at, comment down below with them, or just give us a like and subscribe. Thanks, everybody.